1976. I am submitted to your destiny. From a discourse given by Avatar Adhidhar in the 1970s. Franklin Jones was born into an ordinary American household. He was not born in a manger, nor was he surrounded by religion and classical art. One would wish to be born in the presence of strong and real God-realizing people, with kings coming to visit bearing frankincense, myrrh, and gold. Yet, he did not see anything like that. In fact, in the moment he was born, he nearly died. His umbilical cord was wrapped around his neck, and he nearly choked to death. When he did open his eyes, he was totally conscious of what his surroundings were all about. His entire life is an expression of his prior intuition of divine enjoyment. Who knows where this enjoyment came from? I cannot account for it. A very difficult vision of existence appeared before him. He saw the stupidity and lovelessness of people's lives, their willingness to tolerate an entire lifetime of frustration, obscenity, fear, and all the things that make humankind ego-possessed. Therefore, he took all of that on and lived it just like you, except that he did it consciously as a service to those who suffer. Therefore, even today, I appear to be like the people among whom I was born. I appear to be like you. On the other hand, I am not like you at all, because I have never believed this misery. From the very beginning of my existence, under the most dreadful circumstances, I have been possessed by this prior realization. That coincidence of divine realization and dreadfully ordinary circumstances is what characterizes your spiritual master. I am suited to this time, which is not an archetypal time in which you simply believe in all kinds of fairy tale things about God. You are not even certain that there is a God. All you see is the stupidity of the last generation. Therefore, it is a complicated affair to communicate real God in this late time or dark epoch. Yet, I am the same one that has appeared to one or another significant degree in more archetypal times, the same one, but now fully incarnated. My devotees represent the experience of the late time, and you are what I confront, therefore. My experience must be submitted to an apparent destiny similar to yours. This is the final and complete incarnation of the same one who has incarnated to transform ordinary people throughout all of human history. Duh.